Hello and welcome to Codeva Training Bootcamp. I am Vivek from Codeva team, and in this live session, we are going to explore wonders of AI through object detection in PictoBlox Python environment. I hope you all have registered for the Innovation Fest, Codeva 5.0 International. If not, then do check out the registration video in linked below in the description box. And if you are registered successfully, give me a thumbs up in the chat box. So let's get started with today's session. Today's session is focused on object detection, what object detection is, and how it analyzes the objects. We are going to learn about that. There will be some theoretical part, and we will also be making an activity as well. So let's look at what exactly we will be covering in this particular session. As already mentioned, we will first understand what exactly object detection is. And after that, I will be showing you some functions of object detection and where you can learn more about functions of various extensions that are there in the PictoBlox application. With that, an engaging activity that we already have talked about. So let's get started. So first of all, let us understand what exactly is object detection. What comes in your mind when I say object detection? Like, you know, when I place an object in front of you, what do you, you know, by looking at it, I recognize this as it is a mobile phone, right? By looking at this, I recognize, okay, this is QWERTY. By looking at something else, I will recognize, okay, this is Lego, right? So this is something, what I can say as humans object detection is like detecting various objects. Right now, if I ask you, hey, look around yourself and see what are the various objects that you recognize, right? I can say I have a pen stand in which I have various color pens. Then I have candle. Then I have a mobile phone, my Lego set, my water bottle, my camera setup. So everything is over here, right? So these are the things that are here in front of me, right? So object detection is basically a technique that was already there in humans to analyze or categorize the objects. We are giving that particular technique to the machines or to the computer. It's just basically computer vision. Because we are giving that technique of pinpointing or categorizing. These are the two words that are used on the slide also. Pinpointing or categorizing objects within images or video frames. So, right, if I click an image of my desk setup and post it in one of the object detection activity or the object detection code, it will be able to detect multiple objects like water bottle, phone, candle, QWERTY, pen stand, calendar. So these are the things that it will be able to detect. Right. Basically, there are four steps that are being followed in object detection. So if you remember when we were doing phase detection, phase detection also follows some set of steps. Same way object detection follows some set of steps. First is acquiring the image, either using camera, either you have to upload the image or the video, whatever that might be. Acquiring the data from the image. That is the first process, right? The second process that comes, processing of the data that is being gathered. That means, processing means I am able to process. I am able to analyze, I am able to detect the objects that are there in the image, right? After processing, after detection or processing, you can call it a detection also. I analyze, or the computer analyze, which is the object that is being detected, right? So when I was in sixth or seventh standard, me and my friends used to play a game. In that game, what we used to do, we used to take a box in which we used to put multiple things, multiple various objects like sharpener, pen, pencil, eraser, pouch, and extra things. So we used to put a lot of things in that box, and then we used to cover it up, close it. Then one of the person takes a turn. We open the box, he or she looks at that in that box for, let's say, 10 seconds. After that, we used to close the lid and we used to ask them that, now tell us what were the objects in the box. And the number of the how many number of objects they were able to tell, that many points they will get. The one who will get the most number of points will win the game. So that is something I would say was our technique of object detection, but now we are picking that technique from ourselves and giving it to the computer, right? So analyzing is a part in which we are asking the computer to recognize the detected objects, right? And the fourth is decide and act based on that information. So let's say if I want the computer, if water bottle is detected, then I wanted to see if the water bottle is of plastic or metal. And if it detects that, oh, it is of plastic, then it will act accordingly and say, recycle it or do not throw it out near the water, near water bodies. Do not throw it out near animals. Just don't throw it out. Recycle it. Put it in the dustbin. And if it is a metal water bottle, then you can tell them that you are doing a good job. You are you can reuse it as many times as you want until it's completely worn out, and then again you can recycle it. So that is something that you can say, right? So first is acquiring, second is processing, third is analyzing, and the fourth is acting. So this is object detection. Object detection is a computer vision technique focused on pinpointing or categorizing objects within images or video frames. So that is object detection, right? So these are the Python functions for object detection. So these are the functions, as you can see, video, enable box, disable box, set threshold, analyze camera, analyze stage, count is detected, detected count. That is something. These are the like the normal functions. And I think these functions are named such way that in such a way that you are able to understand what the function is capable to do by just reading out the name, right? Video is just to turn on the video. Enable box is to enable the bounding box. I talked about bounding box in the previous lecture. So bounding box is basically a box that comes up or surrounds your face or any particular object in this case. Then disable box, you can disable that bounding box. Then there is set threshold. You can set the confidence level of the machine or the computer, right? If the confidence level is less than 0.4, then we don't want it to say that. If it is more than that or equals to that, then yeah, surely the computer can say that this is the object that is being detected. Then there is analyze camera. Analyze the image directly from camera. You can use that. Or analyze stage. So let's say if I'm uploading an image, I can analyze directly it from stage as well. Then we have count. It will help us to count the number of objects that are there in a video frame or an image that has been uploaded on the stage. Then we have is detected. So let's say if I want to check if the bus is detected or not, then I can use is detected. And let's say if I want to detect how many buses are there in an image, then I can use detected count. So these are like some of the functions of object detection. I just briefly explained it to you orally. Now I will just want also show you one page which I showed in the previous session also, the extension page. Usually I call it PictoBlocks encyclopedia page, because that is where you will get everything about every extension, whether it be advanced following robot, advanced line following robot, Quarky robot, or block palette, Python functions. Everything is over there on that page. So let me take you once again on that page and show some of the object detection functions there as well. So once you open the PictoBlocks extension page, you can go into object detection, and this is where you will find like all the objects that are that can be identified by PictoBlocks. So there are 90 objects, and you can see even category is given over here. And with that, you know how you can access object detection block coding. Then all the blocks are explained over here. After this, There are block coding examples also. Then we have Python functions. All of the Python functions are explained over here. With that, so let's say if I want to know more about video, I can just right click it or just click it, but I'm opening it in another tab. So if I open it in another tab, the page will open up in which I will see everything about the video function, as you can see, which Python library it belongs to. Function definition is also here. Library import, how you can import the library of object detection. What is the mode in which this function will be executed? The parameters, the first parameter, second parameter, right? And what are the expected values of the parameters? Description of the parameter. Then we have examples also. So you can see there are various examples of this particular function. So this is something that I call as picture blocks encyclopedia, and it will help you out to understand extensions in a much better way. So you can see all of the extensions are here, right? So scratch based default extension, motion, look, sound, control, and everything. Then artificial intelligence, human body detection, face detection, ChatGPT, text to speech, OpenCV. Then the innovative extensions also are over here. Machine learning extensions, quirky extensions are also here. So you see all of the extensions are here to help you out. So let's head back to our PPT. So that was about the functions of object detection. Now let's move to the activity. So this is the activity that we are going to make. So we just have to make an AI object seeker activity in which we will be writing a code. It will perform object detection. It will detect the objects that are over there, and then we will be able to identify it. Basically, this is what the output will look like. Of course, you can get you can use any other image that you like, but make sure the image is clear and it is fitting on the stage, right? Okay, so let's head to the picture blocks and start our code. So now I have opened the picture blocks and opened the Python environment as well. So first of all, what do we need to do is delete the Toby sprite. Okay, after this, we will go in the sprite library and choose the square box as our sprite. This is the sprite in which we will code. So the square box is right over here. Okay. After this, let's start up with the most important part, and that is going to be, first of all, we have to import all the functions, object detection functions, right? We have to import the particular functions. So for that, if you remember on the page, it was mentioned, OD equals to object detection. That is something that we need to write. Object detection, sorry. After that, done. Okay, now all of the object detection functions will be loaded in the OD, right? Or you can name it OBJ also. So it's up to you. You can name it OBJ or OD. That is totally up to you, right? Okay, then we have to also load in pen extension. So pen extension is basically to help you out for stamping the objects, because we are going to use square box. So what I want is, so let's say if I show this, or this is the photo that has been uploaded, right? The photo of a mobile phone. Then I want this square box to stamp itself on the mobile phone and say out the name of the object that is detected, that is mobile phone, right? For example, right? So now what we will do, we will just load the pen extension. And after that, what we are going to do, we are going to clear the pen, like clear, you are going to use a clear function, not clear the pen, sorry. Clear function will help us to clear out all of these stamps that were there, which like that were there present. If we are rerunning the code, like if we are rerunning the code, I don't want the stamps that were already there to be again present when I'm rerunning the code, right? I want a clear, nice screen or clear, nice stage. So therefore, we'll use pen.clear to clear out any stamping that has been there. After this, we are going to set the threshold. Threshold, if you remember in the previous lecture, I said threshold is basically setting up the confidence level of the machine. So if the confidence level is 0.5 or above, then only it will do the following things. Following things, detection, right? So obj dot set threshold, and we are going to set the threshold to particularly 0.5 in our case over here. So 0.5. After this, what I'm going to do, I am going to do the one of the most important thing that is going to analyze the stage. If you are not going to use analyze stage function, the code will not execute properly, right? So you have to make sure you are using obj dot analyze stage function. This will help you out to analyze the stage that is there. Make sure the analyze spelling is correct. So in some cases, the analyze stage is the instead of y or sorry s, some people use z, but here it will be using s only. I think that is what the basic function is, but you can try z also or z also. Okay, after this, we are going to disable the box because I don't want the box, the bounding box, to be enabled. So I will just write obj.disable box, and it will disable the bounding box because that is something that I don't want in our case. Because in our case, we are already using square box as our bounding box, as a default bounding box. So I don't think, you know, having one extra box will make sense, right? Okay. Now comes the most important part. I want the square box to go to the X and Y position of the object that is being detected, right? So I'm going to annotate also on my screen. So let's say if this is an object, right? Let's say if this is an object. What I want the X and Y position of the object is, let's say, the x position is any x, y, z position is there. Any x or y position is there, right? What I want the particular square box, which is our sprite in this case, to grab itself or to move itself from this place to this place, to the particular object that is being detected. So what I want the object or the object's x and y position, and I want to set the sprite's x and y position on basis of that only. So let's say if the object, that is this one, and the object's x position is equals to 100, for example, and y position is equals to 40, just for example, this is the object's x and y position. After this, what I want the sprite. Sprite is just basically this box. I want the box X and Y position to be the same. 100, 40. This is what I want to do. For this, I will be coding, right? So what I will do, first I will get the X and Y position of the sprite. So how I will do that? I will be using the set X and set Y. That is something that I want. And I want to get the X and Y of the object. So X and Y of the object is obj dot X and obj dot Y. This will store the object's X and Y position. And now if I want to set the sprite's X and Y position, I will use set X and Y, right? So sprite dot set X. And then over here, sprite dot set y. That is what I want to do. Okay. Now you might be wondering that, Vivek, What if there are multiple objects? Then what will happen? So for this, we are going to use a forever or a for loop, not a forever loop, but a for loop. What this for loop will do? This for loop will make sure that each and every object is being identified. The 90 and the any object that comes under the 90 list that is being detected. So for that, what I will do, I will simply just write for I in range, sorry, yeah, in range 1, till when I want it to execute, right? Till when I want it to execute, obj dot count plus 1. That is what I want to do, right? So let's say if there is two, there are two objects that are being detected. What I want to do, I have to make sure that the objects that are being detected are being, the box is there on them and each object is detected. So for that, I'm using a for loop in which I'm declaring one variable I and the starting value will be of 1, right? The starting value of I will be 1. And I want it to the ending value, I want that ending value to be count the number of objects. That means the number of objects plus 1. Number of objects starts from 0, right? Therefore, we are putting it as plus 1. So let's say if there are in total 3 objects. So if I use the count function value will be 2 because it starts from 0, 1, 2. For that, it is like only 3, 0, 1, 2. So till 2 it will go. So the max value will be of count function 2. Therefore, I'm adding it as 2. Sorry, I'm adding it as count plus 1 so that the value will be 3. Right? So it will match the actual value of the objects that are present there. So this is how you will do that. With that, let's say if there is an object that is of double the size of the previous object, how we can do this? So of course, having this same box on top of this object will look weird, right? It will not look good. It will not look good at all. So how can I do that? I will be setting up the x and y position is already being set up, but I will be setting up the width of the object. Or width of this or the size of the sprite to the width of the object. That is something that I will do, right? So I will just clear my screen. Just one second. Okay. So what I will do, I will just type, how can I get the width first? Obj dot width of the object. Object will be I in this case, right? It will be I. And I have to set the size of this square box to the width of the object. So for that, I will just use sprite dot set size to the width of the object. So that part is done. After this, I also wanted to say the name of the object that is being detected. So sprite, dot say what I wanted to say, class name that is being detected. So obj dot class name of I is the object. After that, I wanted to pen dot stamp. So the stamp function is just going to stamp the box on different objects, right? It will stamp the box on different objects. Okay. And if you want, you can add some waiting point also here. Let's do that as well. So I will just import time and I will add waiting point as so here let's add some 2 seconds of time, waiting time. Time dot sleep or 1 second or 2 seconds, it's up to you. Okay. Now all I need to do is add one backdrop and run the code. So you can either choose any backdrop or that you like to download. or you can download any backdrop that you find to be interesting, right? But I'm just using the backdrop that I already have. So I will just upload the backdrop. So what you can do for uploading the backdrop, just click on this, hover your mouse on it, and then click on upload backdrop. After that, just select the backdrop that you want to choose, and it will be importing it. And once it's done importing, the backdrop will be there on the stage. So yep, the backdrop is here. I can go back in Python coding and then click on square box and just click on run. So let's see how it will detect the objects. And after that, make sure that you are saving your programs, because if you're not going to save your programs, it's not going to help you out winning the code ever, right? So to brush up your skills, to revise any concepts, make sure you are saving your programs. Make sure you are sharing screenshots or videos of your programs in the WhatsApp or Telegram groups. And this will motivate us, right? So you have to just wait for a while so that models are being loaded. And once the models are loaded, it will start the execution process. So there is one mistake in my code over here. So when I was executing it, it just executed like this. All of these squares are at the same place, right? The reason is this, that I am not, you know, changing the OBJs, the objects, X and Y position as per the new object detection. So I just have to type I in over here and then run it. And once it will start executing, and you will be able to see the change. So you just have to wait a little patiently so that the models are successfully loaded. And once the models are loaded, it will be starting up with the execution process. Bicycle, person, and then car. So you see, it is working perfectly fine. So that was about the object detection. All you have to do now is just save this with the name of object detection in bracket to type py so you are not confused, and then hit on save button. All right, so now this is being saved. Let's head back to the PPT then. So this is the whole code that you guys can see on your screen, as well as you were able to see it on the picture blocks. So I hope you have enjoyed this session. If then, do share your feedback in the comment section, like this session, and make sure that you are sharing some clips or screenshots of the activities that you are performing at your home or in your school on WhatsApp or the Telegram group. So you can join the WhatsApp or Telegram group by scanning the QR codes that are there in front of you. You can ask your queries anytime in these groups, or also you can mail us at codeever@thestempedia.com. So thank you so much for tuning in for this session. I hope you have enjoyed, and I hope you have learned something new. Thank you so much. We will see you in the next session. Bye-bye.